Hi friends, in my last video, I have explained about one of the new features that got introduced in Angular 19, Linked Signal. In this video, I'm going to talk about another interesting feature of Angular 19, Resource API. Resource API is a new reactive API which can be used for handling asynchronous operations, particularly for fetching and managing data from remote sources. This new Resource API leverages Signals, a reactive primitive, to provide a more concise and intuitive way to handle data loading and updates. Instead of theory, let me use a simple example to explain this concept. In this application, I'm just fetching some data from a remote API and showing them in the HTML using for loop. Here, I'm using our traditional HTTP client approach. And so, if I refresh this, we can see these products are showing up. Okay, now let me show you how we can start using Resource API. I can use this rxResource function to which I can pass a rxResource options object. And inside this object, I need to use this loader function. This loader function is the only required function. We do have other functions also, but they are optional. Okay. And this loader function should return an observable. I am going to return this. We don't want to subscribe. Like our async pipe, it will automatically take care of subscription and unsubscription. Okay, this rxResource function will return a resource ref object. Let's create a new variable and get this reference there. Okay, now in the HTML, instead of products, we can use this resource ref. We need to invoke the value function in it to get the actual data. That's it. Let's test this. We can see we are able to get the data. But you may have a question that why do we need to use this new resource API? The answer is this resource API provides a more declarative way to fetch data. Moreover, it has built-in error handling also. Let me show you. Like this value function, we have a status function which will return a status code to us. This is the status code and status mapping. So let me introduce an if condition to check whether my request has been resolved. If yes, let me show this product list. Otherwise, let me check whether the status is loading. If so, let me show a loading text. Let me also handle the error using the respective status code. For now, let me just show a message. Okay, let us test. If I refresh, we can see it is loading first and then it is showing the content. Instead of this loading text, we can use some spinner code to show some good spinner. Okay. To test the error scenario, let me add some junk characters in the API URL. Now we can see it is loading first and showing the error message. Hope you understood. Let me revert this. Okay, good. And if your request is going to observable based and when you are using the HTTP client, you can use this rxResource function. Sometimes we may need to use a promise based request where we may be using the fetch function. In that case, instead of rxResource function, we can use resource function. We can see this is also working. Okay, before we close, let me point out something. If I move this call from the constructor to ng-oninit, this will not work because resource API can only be used within an injection context. So the ideal place to use this is inside constructor. Also, this feature is still in developer preview. Most probably, we can expect this to be stable in the next release. Hope you understood. That's all for today. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.